So you can like screen cap and like go look back at things. It's really good for raids too. I just always forget to like utilize it. What do I wanna?
I can't click and hunt for some reason.
Like I mean, you can't either, click anything?
I can't click in hunt now. Let me unplug my controller. Plugging my controller did not work.
Oh, Remy says the rare bug and you gotta restart. A rare
Pog
bug.
Champ, dude.
You found it.
You found the
Remy
rare
coming
bug.
In. So that's a shiny Pokemon you got there. Damn, thanks.
The shiny Pokemon that breaks your game.
Kind of amazing. Und. Remy says, don't alt tab while it's loading.
Well, alt tab while it's loading. I'm a streamer. I live alt tabbing.
Breathe alt tabbing.
Yeah, Hunt hates alt-tabbers.
Who doesn't, really?
You must be so quiet.
I did also have one more funny 6-hour long test you can run too.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. So let me know if you wanna, you're gonna be away from your computer for an extended period of time.
Thanks for the dramatic pause. I really appreciated that.
Yeah.
P.
Oh, I'll
think about
I'm sorry.
It.
P.
P.
Oh, it's Poopy PP Man 69. Hi. Oh, I put a man in there. That's not your name. I'm sorry.
Did you just assume Poopy?
Yeah, I did.
I do like the lethargic tag, though.
I'll see two.
I have to get. Well, where's Baron? Why can't I see his little high stalker thing?
Is he hiding behind Mimi or me?
He might be behind.
You might have to move.
Mimi's head's too fat.
Oh, he's behind you.
Me?
Oh. I have a beard.
My head's too fat.
I just I looked over.
Head's
and
literally too fat.
I was hiding behind the inn the whole time.
What's the inn stand for?
Hi there, sweetie pie. Do you know what this inn on my forehead stands for?
Does it mean
nice? Maybe.
Oh,
you guys ready to
right
set? Are you guys ready to set those birds off? Classic. Classic, dude.
It wasn't me, dude. It was me.
We're not here to win, dude.
Bro, I took a wide berth from that bird and it still crawled.
Yeah, I bet. Risky, can you stop? I'm Risky, you're so lucky Illuminar is dead. Oh my god, my ears.
I'm Megan Sullivan, creator of the podcast series History in Games, where I play video games and talk about the real history behind the game.
No.
In my last Game Explained video, I talked about the real-life origins of Tom Nook, the generous and possibly very old Tanuki with a heart of gold. Now I want to talk about my favorite villager, one whom I think is even more misunderstood than Tom Nook and has an even cooler connection to our history, Anka. Now some of you may be thinking, wait, who's Anka? Well, for those who don't know, Anka is a snooty cat who loves to gossip about her fellow villagers, refers to you as a peasant, isn't afraid to kick you out of her house, makes all sorts of crazy demands, and constantly insists she's the most fabulous villager in the whole wide world. Which admittedly doesn't always make her very likable. But as it turns out, Anka is a pretty cool cat with a real appreciation for history. And unlike all the other snooty villagers you meet in,
I have to do this entire match with Watch Mojo Girl talking to me about Anka from Animal Crossing. Oh my god.
Ancient heritage. Anka,
it's literally the Watch Mojo Girl.
The ancient Egyptian word ankh, meaning life, looks like she hails from Egypt, where for thousands of years cats were considered sacred. They were closely connected to a number of gods and goddesses, including the fearsome lion goddess Sekhmet and the gentle cat goddess Bastet. Both of these goddesses had major festivals held in their honor, which included lots of drinking, singing, and dancing. Cats were so revered that an inscription.
Doesn't matter for this game, Cole. This game's not gonna run fucking higher than 60 anyways.
Cat, the avenger of the gods, the judge of words, the president of the sovereign chiefs, and the governor of the holy circle. You are indeed the great cat. This reverence for cats may come from the early days of agriculture, when cats would chase off disease-carrying rodents and poisonous snakes from the fields. Thus, the grateful Egyptians began to view the cat as a kind of demigod, one always looking out for them. And I mean literally. Since a cat's eyes glow in the dark due to the reflective nature, the ancient Egyptians believed cats could spot evil spirits lurking in the dark, which is why some Egyptians had their tombs painted with murals featuring cats with eyes outlined in gold. These sparkling eyes were thought to protect a person's mummy while their spirit enjoyed the afterlife. Now, admittedly, Anka's more likely to give you the evil eye than guard you from it. But hey, that's only if you keep pestering her for no reason. In short, Anka's snooty attitude stems from the fact that she's used to being treated as semi-divine, a fact she tactfully refrains from pointing out during conversations. Instead, she talks about fashion, film, or the latest town gossip. But wait, doesn't that make her kind of vapid? You'd think so, but once again, this is a case of Anka being misunderstood. She may love clothes and makeup, but her goal isn't to be a fashion designer or a movie star. No, Anka is much more ambitious than that. She wants to be an astronaut. And why not? I mean, who better to
How
be
did this bimbo make a fucking 20-minute video on Anka?
Ancient Egyptians, who were brilliant astronomers. For example, they built their pyramids and temples so that they would
always align with the Egyptian history. She's not even talking about the character anymore.
And even the equinoxes, like the temple of Setet in Elephantine, possibly built to align with the heliacal rising of the star Sirius, also known as Sothis or Sokhtet, whose appearance in the dawn sky signaled the annual flooding of the Nile and the start of the ancient Egyptian New Year. The ancient Egyptians also synchronized the mummification process so that it took 70 days, the exact amount of time Sokhtet remains hidden below the horizon every year. They loved stars so much they even believed their souls would become stars in the afterlife. And
I know what you're talking about, Baron, the fucking MatPat video.
Known as star clocks, on the inside lid of their coffins in order to help them either find their way to the stars or instruct them on how to behave as a star. Now you might be thinking, yeah, but all that requires complex mathematics. And
what does this have to do with Mario?
Oh yeah, we'll take a gander at Anka's makeup. See her fancy eyeliner? Part of that design might be based on math.
They might be heading
the
this
ancient
way.
Egyptians wore eyeliner around their eyes to protect them from the harsh desert sun.
Hellhounds.
But they also sometimes drew a symbol around their eyes, known as the Eye of Horus, which they believed would bring
that
them health
I'm
and
the
protect them
from
evil. And not only was this fancy eyeliner protective, it was mathematically correct. According to a very popular theory known as the Wajid fractions, the different parts of the eye represent various mathematical fractions, which were used for specific measurements. Yes, the Egyptians were so smart it's possible that even their makeup was tied to math. What the hell? Get out of my makeup now. At any rate, you could argue that Anka's eyeliner is proof she's a mathematical
genius. Is that a full tomahawk
hit?
Does that much?
Okay, so that's a stretch.
You throw it,
but whether or not she's
and then you
still
hit him with a heavy
ship's manual, and it's not like cats can read and write.
So it's effectively
yeah, well,
hits.
This one. Not only is Anka
gone, Mimi.
Which, by the way, the legendary Egyptian queen Cleopatra credited for her health and beauty. If you visit Anka's house, you'll notice the walls are plastered in hieroglyphics, and you have to be pretty smart to be able to read those. Hieroglyphics, sometimes shortened to hieroglyphs, which comes from the Greek holy words, which in turn comes from the Egyptian hieroglyph, meaning the words of God, are pictograms composed of three types of signs. Logograms, representing words.
Yeah.
Phonograms, representing sounds. And
a dog came inside!
Placed at the
what?
End of a word to help clarify its meaning. Hieroglyphics
sorry,
can
I
be wrong, left to right, right to left, or up to down. Which way you read them depends on which
giving
way
the good old three combo.
If they're all facing left, then the author wants you to read from left
I think
to
if
right.
You hit them with
there's another axe right there.
Right, then you read from right to
if.
Left.
You're gonna
and
hit him with like one heavy
from top
and it's not gonna matter.
You still know which column to start with because the characters will all be facing left or right. There are tons of hieroglyphics, as many as there are. Thus, many Egyptians decided to simplify
white
by using an abbreviated
white until
form
death.
Of hieroglyphics known as hieratic, which was easier to write and always written in the
don't
same direction,
to
right
to
left. Both hieratic and hieroglyphics are found in Anka's home, suggesting
let's
she
see, where's
can
the
read
other
both.
Team?
And although the floor
still,
and wallpaper don't seem to spell out anything in particular, the fact that hieroglyphics are everywhere shows Anka has a vested interest in them. But hieroglyphics are not the only evidence we have that Anka is smarter than she lets on. Take a look at the rest of the box. It's awesome. It's like a literal museum bursting with educational opportunities. For example, see the pyramid with a missing capstone smack in the middle of the room? It's an exact replica of the Great Pyramid of Giza, which dates to about 2560 BCE and took up
did
to
we all get
those
fucking
there
only me because I killed it?
Built in honor of the pharaoh Khufu, this pyramid
whoever kills
was the
it
world's
last,
tallest structure for thousands
hits
of
last.
Years. Right up until the Middle Ages. It was made using over 2 million stones weighing 3 tons each and was encased in polished
yeah,
limestone
really much,
and possibly capped with gold, which would have made it shine brilliantly in the surrounding desert, suggesting Khufu wanted to make a real impression. By the way, fun fact, Anka's Japanese catchphrase, Khufu, is a possible play on the word Khufu, the name of the pharaoh associated with the Great Pyramid of Giza, and the Japanese words kuku, meaning giggle, and hoo-hoo-hoo, which is
Effort,
kind
did
of
I,
like ha
did I tell you about the
as
door
for
tech
English
that
catchphrase, me-meow, that's pretty clever too,
the
since mew or meow
shooting the door open kills whoever's on the other side?
Egyptian.
No.
The pyramid
I
isn't the
thing
only
I told
cool
you,
thing about
pull
Anka's
it,
house.
Like
take a look
oh,
at
you hold F and you walk backwards and you slightly open the door ajar.
That too is very representative.
Like normally,
of
when you close
Egypt.
A door,
but you have to be crouching
what
for
were
it.
Weighing?
No.
Well, as it turns out,
if you crouch,
their heart.
You just
you see, the heart was a key to a person's rebirth in ancient Egypt. It was thought to be the source of human wisdom,
but that's how you,
emotion,
that's how you position
memory,
the doors to give you
soul,
like sneaky
and
angles,
even
like,
someone's
now
personality.
I can hit
therefore,
from this
the heart was the only
it, like,
organ not removed during mummification. So that the deceased could take it with them to the Hall of Judgment, where the god of the underworld, Osiris, along with 42
yeah, if you
judges,
do hit a door,
would watch as the deceased's heart was placed
in a scale
back
and
that would reveal whether
the
person had led
like
a good life or a bad life. If the heart was as light as a feather placed on the other side of the scale,
I think Costco got a door kill
good life,
the other day.
And the judges would allow them to enter the field of reeds, an eternal paradise.
With the penetration,
if the person had lived a bad life,
and then the door swung up and
smacked
them.
By the personification of divine retribution, nice. The goddess Amit, at which point the person ceased to exist. In short, the scales represent a crucial instrument needed in the afterlife.
Like,
and then
this grass
there's Anka's
over here
dining table, also a sarcophagus. This table is home to a gorgeous collection of solid gold cutlery. The ancient Egyptians, or at least the pharaohs, had an impressive collection of gold diningware, which they
would
sure to have buried with them so they could use it in the afterlife. They didn't just take their plates, though. They also brought an impressive amount of food.
Yeah.
Beef, poultry, bread, cheese, garlic, dates, pomegranates, wine, and beer. All of these have been found in ancient Egyptian tombs, ensuring the deceased had a fantastic banquet waiting for them when they reached the afterlife. And finally, on another gold sarcophagus, we see a model of a small squarish building.
I say we leave.
This model looks to be a nod to Egypt's earliest pyramid, the Step Pyramid at Sakkara.
I'm still on this video.
Completed about 4,700 years ago and designed by Imhotep. No, not the character from the Mummy movies. The real Imhotep, an architect and court official credited as the inventor of the pyramids. In short, Anka's entire house is a loving tribute to all
the next time I see Risk in VR, I'm gonna choke him.
Well, okay, maybe not that umbrella in the corner, and maybe not her gold toilet. Ancient Egyptians did have toilets, but they were made of stone, and instead of having Egyptian plumbing, they had a box of sand placed underneath them that was changed by hand. But hey, we can't really fault Anka for foregoing an ancient litter box in exchange for 21st century sensibilities. Besides, it's made of gold, which fits the house and the theme of ancient Egypt perfectly. Now at this point you might think, oh, aren't we supposed to be a
live by the bit or die by the bit?
Artifacts that represent Egypt's life. And didn't she used to wear bandages in previous Animal Crossing games? Well, it's unlikely she's a mummy, but not impossible. Archaeologists have found thousands of mummified cats buried in Egypt, and at least one cat named Tamu or Tom Yao was given an elaborate funeral by its owner, Prince Thutmosis. It's more likely, however, that Anka just really loves ancient Egyptian history. I mean, she's probably an Abyssinian cat after all, one of the oldest cat breeds in the world, and one loved by the ancient Egyptians. Therefore, it's only natural for her to celebrate her heritage, right down to how she dresses. If you look closely, you'll see Anka is wearing an awesome headdress with a cobra on it. This cobra headdress, worn exclusively by the pharaohs, was originally representative of Lower Egypt, which, by the way, was where the cult of the cat goddess Bastet was located. And she's also wearing
God,
a layered
dude.
Necklace and collar, which cats may have actually worn.
This bitch is like, which, by the way, is actually...
If you look at statues of the cat goddess Bastet, they often depict her wearing an elaborate necklace that includes an amulet in the shape of the Eye of Horus, which we talked about earlier. This shape has also been called the All-Seeing Eye, or the Eye of Ra, who was the Egyptian sun god. Bastet was sometimes called the Eye of Ra, in honor of her role as one of Ra's watchful guardians against the evil serpent.
If she didn't sound like
Watch
Mojo, it'd be fine.
And so it made sense to portray her wearing a necklace bearing the symbol of Ra, and thus Anka wearing a necklace
what
or a collar isn't out of place. As for her blue hair or wig,
green, are
it
you
wouldn't
in
be
here?
Out of place in ancient Egypt either. Thousands
green?
Of years ago,
green
Egyptian
bunny?
Nobility loved
what
wearing
problem,
hair extensions
green?
And wigs, and it wasn't unheard of to dye their wigs red, green, or even blue. So there you go. In conclusion, it's clear there's more to Anka than meets the eye of Horus or maybe Ra. Even
no
though
way,
she
dude,
may seem shallow
again.
And snobby, she's actually smart, well-versed in history, and fashion-savvy. And if you spend enough time talking to her, it turns out she's way friendlier than you think. Well, most of the time. Okay, some of the time. Hey, at least she doesn't make you hail her with Ankh, Uja, Seneb, which was frequently used in writing to wish the pharaoh life, strength, and health. See, isn't that nice of her? Which Animal Crossing villager is your favorite? Interested in learning more about them?
I
leave
only
a comment
recently
below,
discovered
and be sure to follow
grind.
Me at Meg Sullivan on YouTube.
YouTube decided to throw that on my playlist now.
@MEGHAN_IGN on Twitter, Celtic Queen on Twitch, and Celtic_queen_Meg on Instagram. And of course, make sure to subscribe to Game Explained for more on Animal Crossing New Horizons. Thanks so much for watching, guys.
Dude, I can't click again. What the fuck?
Soundtrack as a whole is great.
Fuck is up with your game?
Whoever played this video, I hope your pillow stays warm on both sides tonight.
That's too far. That's out of pocket. Poppy, you can be honest around here.
Poppy's too kind-hearted.
Let me tune in here. Let me listen to this.
Oh, it's already over.
Oh.
It's over now, yeah.
Okay. I guess that's good.
How can I still not click?
What the fuck? Did you alt tab at all?
No.
Huh.
Two river bugs in one night?
You're on a roll, man. I've literally never experienced this bug, by the way, and I play the fuck out of this game. I'm sorry.
I hit play. I'm not touching anything.
Okay.
Touch it.
Touch me harder.
Not because you're a rabbit.
Some people are having the opposite issue where after alt-tabbing from a hunt showdown, it disables their mouse and keyboard.
I mean, my mouse works. It just doesn't work in the game.
Alright, well, in case it works, I'm going to go to the kitchen real quick.
Some people are saying that it's not that your mouse isn't working, but the offset is basically wrong while tabbing to different resolutions.
I can click now.
Check out my pecs, little man!
Game's good. I can't.
Good night, Remy.
Gotta wait on him.
No. What the fuck is this? Oh my god.
Oh no, are those titties?
Booba?
I mean,
oh god.
They're not nude, but... okay. That's just funny, dude.
Is this even getting in? Is there any sound?
No, there's no sound. What the fuck was that? That's a classic right there.
That gave Georgie a belly.
Yeah, Georgie hated that. What the fuck? The worst part is when people donate me videos, it gets put in my watch history. So my YouTube thinks that I watched that like out of my own volition.
Shit.
Which is not at all.
You should not have said that.
What I wanted.
You should not have said that.
I did not know that, but now that could be fuel.
Afro, you should not have said that.
Hey, watch the whole thing. No, it watches it for me. And re-invite me right now. I can click again.
Yeah. Did Georgie come in through the mic?
Yes.
Yes.
I think that was Georgie. He seemed very upset.
He was getting antsy with me. He wanted my attention.
Oh.
What the fuck?
Okay, I see it. What the fuck is that? Okay, what have you tried hosting? Oh. Can you click?
I cannot click.
Fuck.
Try.
I pulled up the Steam overlay and I can't click on anything on the Steam overlay.
And if you hit the Steam overlay again,
it doesn't do anything.
Have you tried changing the resolution like I said? If it like changes anything?
I cannot. Alt Enter does nothing to this game.
Oh, so the keyboard's not working either then.
My keyboard's working. I can click on chat and...
No, I meant in-game.
Nothing's working.
She dashed out.
I mean, it seemed really was working fine. That's how I was accepting the invites before. Try verifying, I guess. Do not think that's a verification thing.
Somebody said that, but I wasn't sure.
Blow out now.
What file would be missing for my fucking mouse to work, but not that the games work? Oh, it's verifying. It's going a little slow.
Oh, it's bad.
You also have your controller unplugged, right?
I did unplug my controller, yes.
They're also saying to make sure your key bindings or your map is rebound so you don't have that issue in game.
Who's saying this?
Like Googling issues who are having to alt chat bug. Sadly, this was only 10 months ago, but God, that means this bug has been around for a long time.
Is Ultra Kill really only a gig?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Risky. This one's called Sexy Blaziken. I'm not sure. Okay.
I am gonna try it.
She wanna be a bad girl.
Oh my god. That might be a bit much.
What the fuck?
Very fucking loud. Hold on.
Yeah, let me just bookmark this real quick.
Yep, there's underboob there. That's unfortunate. If there's underboob, Twitch doesn't like it. For some reason, only underboob. You can have as much cleavage as you like. But... I don't make the rules. Unless you're at the beach. Classic. It's okay, Risky. I enjoy the gag still. It's a funny gag. I don't know what it is about Blaziken though. Can you tell me what about Blaziken that lures you?
The funniest part was when I came.
What? Look, when you... Alright, I validated. Let's see how this works.
It's cool.
She can control internal body temperature. There's ono holes I can do that thing. Come with a little like slider. Maybe it's like USB powered.
Wretched. The quality is so shit.
Oh, this is a classic.
Why is this on the recommended page for me, dude? Did you fast to Final Fantasy 14?
Whoa, so... I can't click again, dude. What is this game?
What the fuck?
What is going on?
I see two pterodactyls, but oh my god. Alright. What if you hosted the game and you invited us?
How am I going to do that if I can't click?
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Time to restore balance to your watch list.
Instead of pressing play on the game, would that do any difference?
This is a good video.
It sounds like a monkey.
Last troubleshoot.
Yeah.
This is a great video. This is a classic. One of like the first videos I ferreted on YouTube. Just like 15 years old.
That thing?
Is this Eleanor? Eleanor video. It was Poppy. Poppy donated. What the fuck? Poppy don't give me money. I'm too dirty to give money to.
What does that even mean?
There he is. That's recording. Leave my kayak. Hello.
No. Be good. Don't chew anything. Please be recording. No. Get off. Be nice.
I had a dream last night. Ree was a pterodactyl, but that's beside the point. And when I was humane in my dream, Ree hooked up with women as far as the eye could see, and maybe two or three. Ree knew these women. Ree went to school with
them,
but every time I touched, I and kissed, I and
nuzzled. If I hid in my friend's gonna bring up the overlay.
Ree was disgusted, and it hurt. And as a pterodactyl, Ree couldn't glide.
He's got because I'm hanging on you for dear life.
Okay, oh, fuck, you can't.
I'm in.
Bad.
I'm in and I can click. That'd be crazy if this happens in the middle of the match. That's gonna be very crazy, wacky, goofy.
I was gonna say to have your like Steam friends window open or something and then just right click us that way.
I like the funny seal.
Thank you, Poppy.
The funny seal is pretty nice.
Eels are cute.
Eels are just water dogs.
Streamer help. After looking at Blaziken videos, I somehow stumbled upon Dinosaur Vor videos. I would donate them, but I'm sure they are not as safe.
Risky, I'm not into that type of war. I would not want to watch them. I don't know how, where were that connection? Of course it's a night map, dude.
Oh, Mimi, look.
Hmm?
I'm a fed, you're a sheriff, and he's the convict.
The crackhead, you mean? Actual convict?
Yeah. Convict in question.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Dude, how did... Are you fucking kidding me?
You might have hit her arm.
Bro, she ate two of my small bars. Kind of impressive, actually.
Let's see where you can find it. Yeah, there's a medkit for you right there.
Yeah. I figured there would be one in here somewhere.
There's gonna be birds right up above. Wonder if I can.
Move out of my fucking way, Jesus Christ.
What are you looking for?
Huh? I'm moving on. I figured. figured that he was giving me the clue.
No one's gotten the clue yet. I'm grabbing it now.
Oh. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Dude, why are there so many fucking hive cunts?
Yeah.
Holy. I can't see shit in this map.
It's dark. Looks like it's gonna be up on the second floor in the prison.
Is that you guys?
The shots or the footsteps?
Shots.
No, that's too far out. Oh yeah, it's right there.
I'm getting it.
Can I serpent this?
Yeah, I'm getting it.
Oh, you're already serpenting it?
Yeah, I'm halfway.
Fuck you, bloody. Windy Brian.
Quality videos are funny. I mean, you can DM them.
Birds. I don't think that was me.
Northwest. Yeah, we gotta get in that compound quick.
I'm heading south with you because I don't want to be out in the open world. I was really close to those birds. See snakes over there. Are you grabbing them?
I don't see grabbing snakes. Me.
You ran by two of them.
Of course, there's dogs right there. Let's see, the clue's gonna be inside the building.
Probably serpented if I get close to this wall.
I'm gonna go around the long way through the back so I don't make as much noise.
There are snakes right up here too. You see them, Afra?
Yeah. I'm getting the clue.
Are you getting it? Okay. Make it the snakes from right here. Alright, you got it?
Yeah, so Arden Parish, it seems.
That's probably where the people went.
Yeah, the issue was we heard the birds, but we didn't see which direction they went in.
Yeah, they probably just ended up going to Parish. Maybe they saw me, I don't know.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, there's definitely gonna be players at Parish.
I guess it's a big ol' open area they can shoot us from, too. That hive is still angry, what the fuck?
Those are dogs.
Is my gun glow in the dark too much?
Not really.
They're already fighting it then.
Yep.
I don't see any movement out here. I have 11. I want to burn. I see it over to the southwest.
They're meleeing it.
They just killed him, I think.
Yeah.
So there's one right there if you want to risk running at it.
No, it's so not open. I mean, you guys are kind of in there. I'm under. Is it under or is it in the building?
It's inside.
I hear a horse. There's someone outside. Or no, I hear them in the wood. Never mind. Who's three? Rhino. I think they're near you.
Oh. I'm under the fucking.
Oh, that's you then.
You're still messing with the concertina wire in there.
I hear so many footsteps.
Only had a shotgun. Ooh, that's a fucking horse. That's dangerous.
Oh, you bitch.
Damn it. Okay. Yeah, they probably heard that. I'm on the opposite side of you though right now.
He wasn't even looking at me and he got alerted. One.
I saw them throw on this side.
Fuck.
She died right.
Alright, well they've been alerted. You wanna kill that horse?
Go ahead.
Where are they all here? What is with these zombies today? Oh, oh. They're throwing a dynamite on the second floor. I hear them running.
Got two.
Nice. Fuck, of course he has a shotgun, dude, every time. I can't click again, what the fuck.
Machete part of my gun, dude. I just ran at him.
It worked.
Oh, wait. I'm reviving you, but I don't think you can click.
I can move. I can reload.
What the fuck?
It worked, man.
Dude, I just said fuck it. I ran at him with the machete part of my gun.
My click does work in game. Come on,
dude,
test.
Five bitches going insane.
I can shoot.
Professor now? Oh, Grant,
stop!
I'm just gonna take the lead. Alright, you both got the bounty then?
Mm-hmm.
Oh
so
my
that was
fuck,
one
can we kill this stupid hive?
Go ahead. You can just shoot her at this point.
Yeah. I already
I
had my
11 points.
Account.
Holy fuck.
I burned 11 while you guys were dealing with that. Alright, well. We want to go for the spider or just extract?
Let's see. How far off?
We have a small.
Yeah, we could go dip a toe at Lawson.
On the way, anyways.
You know, Trey can't jammers for A's in his class.
I think me running at that guy freaked him out so much that he missed his shotgun shot.
Yep. He knew I was at the door. I don't think he...
Remember the episode when Mr. Mosley committed vehicular manslaughter because he was driving under the influence?
I'd pretty just good body episode, hit him too. Demo. The fucking machete thing does so much damage.
The second Cody.
You're using the Vetterli right now, right?
Correct.
Yeah, the bayonets are pretty strong.
I fucking stabbed him in the chest and he died. I didn't even have to shoot.
Scan? Yeah, still clear. Mimi, you're the one without the bounty. Where's the clue?
Right here.
Yeah, that's an emulator. Blanc, I guess. It's 50-50.
Crazy how he was drunk driving then filmed this.
And I can see myself perfectly.
No, they're not for vanity. Your rear view mirrors are missing the view to your rear.
I saw a zombie spawn in, so I don't think anyone's in here.
Driving a motor vehicle is not fun. It's serious business. Have you buckled your seatbelt?
I was going to, but this outfit just wrinkles so easily, so I thought... Just throw it through. Oh, my outfit!
Get below!
Oh, hello, Snake.
Okay. Now, are you familiar with the gear shift?
You mean...
to the shift lever that says P-R-N-D-L.
Did I just shut it?
No, I shot a fucking thing because I had like three things on me and I had no more melee juice.
I'm sorry. Why don't we just relax or turn on the radio? Would you not have...
So where's the clue?
I'm getting it right now. There's snakes up there though, if you want to go up there.
We're not even moving!
Where's the... Okay.
The snakes are up there on the
small battery.
How's he on the roof?
The key in the ignition
for over an hour now.
That's because you had to do your makeup twice.
Well, excuse me for trying to beautify the highways.
Stop the engine.
Yeah, I wouldn't have for me to go up there.
Put the car in drive.
I have 8 right now.
That's the D on the.
Let's go all the way around.
He is more danger here than he is there.
God.
Probably alone at this point, but can't really touch that. Could be a random fucking rat. Like that one game we had. Yes, I meant the bayonet. Listen, Scotch. A knife's a knife. I brain kept going to machete because I saw one the other day.
Yep, nothing.
Alright. Any of you have a sticky?
I can see if I can get one. I got a fake sticky. Fucking chaos bomb.
It's just a spider.
Yeah. Yeah, shovel. Let me see, where's that last clue? It was somewhere in this. There it is. Oh, little bitch. Sledgehammer.
Did you know the spider has a gigantic, like, humanoid face?
Mm-hmm. And his legs are made of arms and legs. Human arms and legs. Spider's been an ongoing war against the Crytek engine for so long. The way it moves is just...
I'm just gonna shoot it.
You can if you want to.
Yeah, I mean, we're broadcasted on the map.
We're still white, so...
Shoot the legs, but it takes more damage.
If one of you all dropped your melee weapon, let me have that.
Where are you?
Hello. Thank you. Thank you. He dropped gator legs. No, it's magpie. There is doctor on the outside to the southeast.
Doctor's extremely good. That's the first perk I always get.
I also have doctor.
All three of us have it?
I think so.
Doctor.
Doctor?
Doctor. Disable my cringe inhibitors.
Yeah, I remember you mentioning it was something good to take, so...
Let's see, we can just go north to Goddard.
Upgrade points here.
To go burn snake.
Yeah, there's a kiln right up here.
It's over there? Okay.
I'm glad I got this hunter. I kind of dig this. I don't mind the fed boy too much.
Is that the new one?
He's a newer one. It's Hawkshaw Jack. I think his whole thing's supposed to be like he's a crooked fed.
So you had the crook and the regular fed. One?
Yeah, I was about to say.
yeah, we're good to just go north.
North.
North. And we're clear. Pretty good.
Minus me not being able to click again.
I mean, you're able click to now.
At least you were able to after our res deal.
Once we get in the menu, I'm not gonna be able to. I think it's a menu thing.
It might be.
Fucking weird though. It just makes no sense.
I've never had this problem. No idea what's going on.
Likewise. Go see if Goddard has a meathead. Nope. It don't sound like it.
God, he takes so long to reload.
What gun are you using?
Betterly still, I think.
No, the pistol.
Let me look at it.
The Shoku?
Yeah.
I think it's a Spitfire.
If it's empty, it's faster.
I swore I did it empty and it was not that much faster.
I can see the casings.
Yeah. Yeah, the thing about the show field is if you unload it individually, you have to pull them out and then put a new one in.
Yeah, I see that now. So it's faster, but it's still a long animation.
There's a Schofield speed loader.
Isn't that the Swift?
Yep.
Yeah, that's the one I was trying to unlock. I just unlocked the Spit.
The thing with the Swift, if you shoot once and then reload, you lose all the bullets inside of it.
Mm-hmm.
So with the Schofield, you really want to make use of all your six shots, no matter what version you're using?
The one you're using right now is probably my favorite. The Spitfire is very good.
Thank you. I remember you saying that.
What makes a Spitfire different?
It, I think it's a snub nose, so it weighs less, so you can cock the hammer faster.
Are you able to press buttons, Afro?
Nope.
What the fuck, man?
Christ.
I have no idea.
Me neither. Fuck, did I unlock? Dynamite bundles.
Plasma asking if you are playing in windowed mode or not.
I was in borderless. As I've always been in the past, like, 3 years I've played this game.
Yeah. Up my workshop in 14. I don't think I set up for
Dude, oh my god. I think I'm done.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
I'm gonna try and fix this.
I don't think that first encounter would have gone the same if the weird sister didn't try peeking out the window. I don't know why she was sneaking around next to the window, right, like trying to look inside the building and not outside. She was moving like parallel to the door. So the first thing I saw pop out was her face. She wasn't even looking at me.
That is a bit strange. Maybe because I was making noise? Maybe that's why she didn't look at you?
Oh, I think she was looking at the window on the side.
That was by the burner on the south side.
Oh, I remember. It's because that fucking zombie that spotted me from behind him somehow.
Right, so she thought I was gonna... wasn't looking at you and it came for you?
he wasn't looking at me, and then got pissed off and then immediately turned around and ran at me. So she thought I was still up there. I guess that kind of worked in my favor.
I can navigate the angels on my controller.
What the fuck?
Do you think... You think if you just use your controller for the menu and then unplugged? Or like in-game?
I mean, I can move my mouse and it goes straight from controller to keyboard and mouse.
Wait, did you plug in your controller?
I plugged it back in, yeah.
Would you want to try that?
And then it worked again?
No, I can't click. I still can't click, but I go through the menus.
Get my pecs, little man!
You have to, like, navigate the menu with the controller or whatever.
Controller gaming.
And then I guess maybe your mouse would work for the end game?
I'd be assuming it would be for menu only. Would you want to try that? We can try one and see if it's scuffed.
Yeah.
I mean, it already is scuffed, but...
It's already scuffed.
How scuffed?
How scuffed is it?
I'm gonna go put something in the oven.
Oven?
Forgot I'd been preheating for a while.
Oh god, I left my oven on.
The IME being the issue?
What is IME?
Were you unable to accept the invite?
Playing with the controller? No, I'm navigating the menu with the controller because I'm not able to click in the game. I can accept the invite, yes.
Okay.
I'm ready. I'll just switch over to the controller when I die and stuff. I can spectate. Thank you, Risky, for the Granny 2 speedrun. Minutes 11 seconds. Extreme boat glitchless.
Like one of those deer hunting games?
Yeah, why don't you play hunt with a light gun?
Is it fucking... Is it a mobile game?
God, Poppy, that reminds me of that dude who... What was it, Dark Souls 3? Or Elden Ring? I think they killed Melania with a dance pad.
What?
Oh yeah, I think there's a guy who's played like every Souls game on a dance pad.
Mm-hmm.
Or, the DK bongos.
Zero Lenny did that.
That's what I was thinking of.
He also beat them with a scuffed looking broken sword controller that was like a Wiimote, I think. He's done so many fucking weird challenges.
My clicks work when I'm playing the game, that's funny.
That's a lot of dogs. That's a white woman heaven over there.
Yeah.
Oh, I killed him with the door.
I threw a tomahawk at him.
Oh, okay.
Sorry to steal your thunder.
I went to click at that zombie, and somehow my mouse acted if I wasn't in the game and clicked on my second monitor.
Yeah, that can happen sometimes.
There's a tiny bounty.
Give jerky for the dogs. We are the jerky. They'll eat us. Oh, nice. I got a dynamite bundle from that. I did not mean to shoot, sorry. I did the funny thing that I hit 3 to change the metal and I did it too early. But our target's here.
So he is. Tina's very unfortunate.
Ow.
I put my hair on, dude.
check and see what weapon he draws.
Yeah, when Scrapbeak screams, it's supposed to deafen him.
Yeah, like he really fucked it up.
Hello.
Oh, hello. Oh, the door closed. Why?
He must have smacked
a sledge.
Him.
Birds?
Me. I went outside to look for a fucking heel.
He takes everything around him, so there's nothing.
I thought there was a medkit for me, but...
Alright, I've got a sledgehammer.
He's dead. White
all the way down.
Lightfoot. Alright, you ready to go burn him?
Burn him?
Points you got.
Yeah, I'm about to go out now.
If the other one's all the way on the other side, I'd really be surprised if they come here.
Putting two bear traps down. Right, and right through this door.
What's up, Corb?
Oh. Dropped a... axe that I can't pick up. With plenty of ammo. Is that a meathead outside?
I believe he's at the front north.
Be silly for a little bit.
Don't be silly, we're still fucking players.
Just be a little silly.
A little silly.
You okay, Rhino?
I'm goofing. No, I'm not. But...
killed one. Right there.
Work. You saved my ass with that. Let me check here.
Grab the bounty.
Just making sure he doesn't get back up.
Yeah. Southwest. Southwest.
Southwest?
Should be two. Oh no, I see him.
Hit.
Fucking.
Gotcha, bitch.
Alright. That's it.
Oh, the other one?
Only two.
Yeah. I suppose so.
You need another scan?
There was only two. I just scanned.
Okay. Well, you can grab that body then.
I got vultures, so you should be able to loot.
Yeah. I'll loot him in just a second.
I also have vulture.
Bloodless.
Bloodless is good. Where is that?
Right up there at the front. The challenge wants me to kill meatheads with melee weapons, so...
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Did you just hit and run them?
I throw, like, two lanterns at him, and then I smack him with, whatever weapon I can find. Those smackings. Any of them have long ammo on him? Bornheim match, and I've been gone. Yeah, I'm glad this dude died, fuck you.
We had a Bornheim?
Bornheim match, and a... Nagant silenced paired.
Can't see what this guy had. This dude died clipped into the mountain. Oh no, this
weapon
is...
slid down.
Oh, I see.
Okay, where are we headed? Oh, we got one right next to us.
Yeah.
Easy.
I was testing the waters to see if there's any devils.
It's okay.
Wait, I need to turn in these tokens. Shit, I have 12.
That's okay. Yeah, I'll just wait over here.
Upgrade points here. I'm full on perks, so I don't really might need them.
Yeah, we're clear.
I don't know how that dude did not shoot you walking back in. He was staring right at your back as soon as you said you were goofing.
He might have been waiting for an opportunity. I saw what you tried. You think you're fucking slick? Yeah, honestly, that dude had me dead to rights. He didn't know I was one shot.
Baron, are you using that sanctuary thing that Jeeves posted?
Oh, I don't know. I didn't see Jeeves post.
Here. I just opened it up. I can link it to you. It's pretty good, honestly, for the weekly workshop.
Wait, where'd Jeeves post that? I assume burn server since you're talking about it.
No, actually in LFGF, but it was like a day or two ago.
Oh shit.
I just sent it to you.
Okay. Oh.
You can even see the weekly shit in there too.
You're in her DMs. I'm on her block list. We are not the same.
Alright, I'll do one more just to see if I can get this dude maxed out. Add in my Coomer collection.
Fingers crossed.
That's not the one I'm using. Sorry to look.
Victor Amelia, sweet monstrous pussy. Good night.
Good night, Risky. Viper Amelia would have crazy sex, I think.
This looks like a full-on breakdown, though.
Yeah, I'll have to, like, see how well it is. Like, it looks like the groove movers aren't the ones I should be doing. I should probably do the second one, Power Pilot ones. Because, like, all my shit's max, so all I'm doing now is just gaining powers or whatever. Reminds me, I forgot to check if my animals were ready or not, but time I get on, I'll do them. I got an antidote? God damn it.
You what?
I don't have an antidote.
Because
I picked up the.
We should be fine as long as we don't run into hives or.
I mean, we will run into hives, but.
Well, as long as you don't run into them at first.
Yeah.
Let someone else deal with them, is what I'm saying.
It was my fault. I forgot that I picked up the dynamite bundle from the consumables last match.
Or players using poison ammo for whatever reason.
I would assume that's kind of meta since you can see poison people through dark sight with the event.
I was doing that for a bit too. Using poison ammo before I got the full metal.
Port Reaker, yeah.
I can sneak past these birds. There's also a horse up ahead, but I don't have anything silent to kill it.
Oh, that's okay. I'm just gonna go this way instead. Right next to the bug lady.
I need kill her.
That sounded kind of like from Alice.
Oh, there's another.
There's a hive right there. Thank you.
Not many direct paths we can take. We're just gonna have to cut through woods and over roads.
Yeah, I guess can be cozy a little bit. There's no cozier game sometimes than Stalker, though. That game can be so nerve-wracking, but also cozy.
The high that attacked? Yeah, there's somebody nearby.
Hit.
Vicar Amelia, sweet monstrous pussy, good night.
They're just out in the open?
Yeah, it was just behind that machine.
Probably another, though. I wouldn't know where.
This fog is not kind.
Idea if it was a solo or not.
I don't know, but there's two birds here and not attack.
Fuck.
I'm out in the open. I did that on purpose to try and get them out.
Came from that direction.
Oh, sorry. I did it again. Fucking changing my shit.
Yeah, he's in the compound. Shooting through the...
Through this? Like...
That's okay.
Yeah.
If they wanna play sniper.
I got no scope.
That's okay.
No, that's true. Make a move out.
Yep.
What the fuck? Another one. With the poison ammo. Hit me. I'm getting fucking shot through the building, dude.
From the back.
That is behind us. That's another team behind us. Oh my god, that's two teams just sandwiching us.
Shooting me. I don't fucking see them. The fuck? Fucking.
Goodbye. Fucking aim punch, dude. It's a garbage game.
I couldn't stand up.
Bunch.
I had a fucking bar up against my head. It's silly.
That was aim punch that got you killed 100%.
I would have been more mobile, but something was blocking me from standing up.
I think it's the fence right there. If you lean too far into it, one of the beams kind of sticks out.
Of course, we get pincered by two teams, dude. I'm done.
Alright. Save for that last one, that was still pretty good.
Yeah, it's pretty okay.
Hey Mimi, what are you at in the event?
I have no idea. Level 9.
Nine, that means...
Or going into level 9? Dude, I don't fucking know how this shit is. It says level 9 on the bar. can't remember if that means I'm level 8 turning 9 or what. I think it's 8 turning 9 because I don't have that gun.
The Sparks pistol?
Yeah, I don't have it.
Yeah. Didn't I check?
I'm guessing I'm level 8.
How far off until you get it?
I'm at 997 out of...
I'll be live again Thursday with probably some VR.
Yeah, you can easily get that with another
Not
session.
VR chat, but like Phasmophobia or something. We'll see. Good night.